So while we're on the topic of thinking different kind of outside the box of the way you typically see Angular examples, there's also another way to set up the way you define controllers themselves and actually directives and services and everything. So if I were to create an object here just called controllers, and then I were to create things like named functions on here, and grab this code from here to there, just basically the function that was being passed in down here. What you can do is pass in this controller's object into app.controller, and then everything will work just the same. So you can see how you're defining an object with you just define the list of all your controllers on there, and you could do the same thing with directives. You do var directives as an object, and then you'd say directives. I think we did a panel recently, and then everything would be the same syntax as usual as far as restrict, E, etc. And then you just pass in app.directive and pass in the directive object. So you can kind of see how that'd be nice. It's a clear separation of where your directives are and what they're attached to, where your controllers are and what they're attached to. I've e even seen the approach where people want to group together the like the phone app. So this is the phone app module. And so we'll create an object called phone app components or stuff, name it whatever you want. And then they'll just say phone app stuff. And they'll start grouping things together that way. And then, you do phone app stuff dot directives and phone app stuff dot controllers. And then everything will, should still work the same, except I didn't define anything for my panel, so it's going to throw some errors there. Actually, sorry, the error is here. It'd have to be this as well as this, and then that should run without any errors. So basically, all this is doing is just kind of grouping things together, putting them into those objects. It actually, for things like WebStorm, it groups them together nicely if you're going to navigate your code. You can see how there's a controllers object, and I can see my list of controllers and the methods in them. Now, again, this kind of goes against the standard convention you'll see everywhere. It also doesn't work on, I believe, filters. You can't go app.filter and then pass in an object that contains all the values of filters. The filter just doesn't the filter method here just doesn't parse that correctly. So it's not, since it's not like the recommended way of doing things, it may kind of be hit or miss when you get into the nitty-gritty stuff. But again, this is all kind of a taste thing that's not going to really interfere with the way you build your app or anything. But if you think you like doing it this way, then go ahead and try it out. It's really easy to refactor out if you don't like it. And it's always good to explore your options.